What's happening, everybody? Welcome to FN's Downtown Studios. I am John Ramdean alongside Robin Black. UFC 207 going down this Friday night marks the return of the former women's 135-pound champion, Ronda Rousey, one of the biggest stars ever in the history of mixed martial arts. She is looking to recapture her 135-pound title when she takes on Amanda Nunes. We all know the media, it's been very, very no for Ronda Rousey. She stayed out of the spotlight, not talking to a whole lot of people. Do you believe this is good? I know you thought it was good leading into it. At the end of the day, this is an entertainment sport. Should she be addressing some of the things that she needs to address?
Well, it depends who you are and what your motives are at the time. I think she's already an entertainment giant. And so she's like, I don't need her personally, doesn't need anything from that. And she wants to focus on the fighting, the getting ready, and the going in and doing it. So I get that. That makes a lot of sense from her perspective. Not talking about what we all want, but from what from her perspective. Empathetically, try to imagine being her. And I just imagine Travis Brown with his arm around me. I didn't like that. I didn't like that at all. But imagine being her, and you're dealing with the things. So you're like, I don't care about the entertainment business. I'm an athlete. I'm going to go win. That's what maybe what she's thinking. There is a dark side to it, even from her perspective. And that's before we start talking about what we, the fans, want, what the UFC wants, justice between these all. Everyone else has to do it, but she doesn't. All that, separate conversations. We can have those if you like. But there's a downside for her, and that is being scrutinized in front of people as millions watch you, potentially boo you, who knows what you're dealing with, the pressure of that. When you insulate yourself from that for a year, what effect does that have? You know, when you try to pretend there's nothing and I'll just concentrate on the fight, what if you get there and you can't? Because you haven't been where somebody has jeered you. You've hidden yourself from it. You have to embrace it. You have to accept it. Some many different ways that athletes and famous people do. Some of them look at hate as a crop that can be harvested for their career.
But can you accept that when you're hidden? When you're away from people, can you spend that year trying to understand yourself and understand what people are trying to do and come to the realization that, you know what, I understand what this is. I'm not going to subscribe to it. I'm just not going to give it any power.
Yes, and that's possible. But you are going to stand in an arena with 16,000 people when you've been trying to interact with none. And in the most, you know, unforgiving circumstances, you don't want to be surprised by the fact that the very thing you've been sheltering yourself from is now an enormous distraction. And as well, the reality, the truth is that you deal with love and hate and celebrity and, you know, just all of that negativity as well as the thing, that's real. So if you deal with it and release it and say, you know, it doesn't mean anything. Engagement of any kind helps my career. I don't know these people and they don't know me. So these are meaningless things. That's dealing with it. That's seeing it and finding a truth in it. Not dealing with it at all is not the same thing. Just pretending it doesn't exist is not the same thing. All the best sports psychology consultants, all of the best athletic psychologists, all of the best people of this type will tell you, you have to make reality reality and address it. And that goes for Cody Garbrandt. We talked about that in another chat, and we've talked about that all week. He's got to deal with the reality that, fine, this guy talks better than me. That doesn't have a bearing on how I deal with this fight emotionally. And Ronda has to deal with the fact that going in and saying, I got something to prove, and I'll prove it too, and I'll be tougher on the night. When you don't deal with things that are tough on the way up, is that training to be tougher on the night, or is that training to not deal with reality?
One of the things Ronda said, though, is she's dealt with issues in the past. During her days competing in judo, just family situations, she has been in dark spots throughout her career. Now this is just a very public one. She said now, you know, everybody, you turn on SportsCenter leading up to this fight, you see the highlight of me being kicked in the head and falling to the ground. I've had to pick myself up many, many times. This is not a unique situation. However, since you're now exposed to the masses, you have to deal with, as like you said, a bunch of strangers sending their hate.
History is just history. Your history is only your history. It's not who you are forever. Just like if once upon a time you didn't know how to play piano and now you do, if you don't play piano for a long, long, long time, you'll be terrible at it. And that goes for mental strength as well. Misha Tate would never give up, was never short of, you know, the cojones to be able to go into the depth as far as she wanted. One night, she won the title, lost it, and then she didn't have it anymore. These things are not permanent. They're not permanent attributes. They're works in progress. And Ronda Rousey, if she's believing that because she's overcome certain things 3 or 4 years ago when she was a different human being with different stimulus and different inputs and different influence and different training and different preparation, she'll be wrong. Matt Brown told you right on the phone, you were asking him about mental strength, and he said, I don't see mental strength as something I am. I see it as something I train ongoing, and I never want it to atrophy. It's like a muscle.
Amanda Nunes, she says she's in a very good place. She's at peace right now, because her goal was to become a UFC champion. She's gotten there. Is that good for her? When you, based on what we've heard in the past, that's only one part of the journey. Getting to the top, and I'm gonna use this word, and I know there's gonna be haters, is the easiest part of becoming a UFC champion, is getting to the top of the mountain. Staying on the top of the mountain seems to be the most difficult place. We talk about all the title defenses. Ronda Rousey's defended the title. Holly Holm didn't, Misha Tate didn't, and we don't know if Amanda Nunes can.
It's true. It's true, man. Saying, I'm in a good place because I'm the champ, Misha said that, you know? And then on the other hand, Max Holloway, every fight says, I'm an 0-0 fighter trying to get to 1-0. I'm an 0-0 fighter. No, I've accomplished nothing. It starts now. That seems to be the modern psychological approach to getting yourself ready for battle. And, you know, Robbie Lawler won the title and then had his best two performances in the battles after. He grew, he set new goals. Amanda Nunes, much like Ronda Rousey, we don't know much about her other than great performances in the cage. And you know what? Good for her, man. This idea that because you're an athlete or because you're an artist or because you're a performer, that means you have to be a celebrity. Why would anybody want to be a celebrity? When they look at the collapse of these people, when they look at the negatives that come with it, she's a fantastic athlete, a fantastic martial artist, with a seemingly happy home life and athletic life. This is good. Don't, and the people who are like, they should be pushing her harder. Maybe she doesn't want that, and who can blame her? Look what happens when you become a famous athletic star. Not only great things, and often not great things at all. Amanda Nunes can go in there, beat the biggest star ever, and do it by doing it the way she's always done it, happy and content in her skills, go in and express them, be free as a martial artist, beat the biggest star ever, and move on with her life going up. She can do that.
Ronda Rousey will certainly have a ton of pressure on her shoulders leading into UFC 207. Will she manage to recapture her bantamweight championship when she takes on Amanda Nunes?